I also hope that students will look into this, because we still have a problem in South Africa. Too many students rushing to course that are of, to programs that we are not short of in South Africa, that are oversubscribed. And that is just breeding unemployment. And we are still, by the way, spending a good percentage of NSFAS money to support students who are not going to get jobs at the end of the day because they are in areas that are not in high demand.
Yeah.
So students also need to look at this list.
Hi guys, today there's a video that I saw on the news and I thought, you know what, let me just replay this video again. The video has got to do with which careers in South Africa are more like you are more likely to get employed. So which careers are in scarcity? Which careers in South Africa you are more likely to get employed? What I was looking at is actually what I'm trying to tell you here about being an analyst, to say, is it something on the pipeline or is it not? The speech was made by Higher Education Minister, so it's not a bogus, and the report is also quite dead. It's very, very comprehensive. Let's just discuss the findings. Let me just replay it.
Today, I'm launching the national list of occupations that are in high demand in South Africa. Many of the occupations on the list can be associated with key areas and sectors identified as crucial for the reconstruction and recovery plan as announced by the president. For instance, it includes the following as critical skills that we are short of: in the digital economy, in energy, there is a whole lot of shortage of skills for energy, in infrastructure development, manufacturing, tourism and agriculture, we are short of data scientists, web developers, computer network technicians, electrical engineers, concentrated solar power process controllers, mechatronic technicians, tool makers, gaming workers, crop produce analysts, agricultural scientists, just to name but a few. I also hope that students will look into this, because we still have a problem in South Africa. Too many students rushing to course that are of, to programs that we are not short of in South Africa, that are oversubscribed, and that is just breeding unemployment.
I think I must commend the minister, number one, for bringing the list. I know most, I don't want to do the data side, the analyst side of things, but from hindsight of things, I think it's a good thing that he still gives us the indication to say, are you in a program or in a course that's in highly demand or not? And I think from that, it's quite powerful. Second thing, universities are now, I think I must commend them, are now taking steps into, you know, warning the person to say, hang on a second, it looks like we already have enough of that. There's a lot of people in the job market in that program. Do you, with your marks, you rather want to do this other program, which is quite nice. I know they did that with me when I started. Well, later UJ. I think they did that to me. They went in and they said, what do you want to do? And then I showed them my marks. And then they said, you can go to the sciences, you can go to, and I said, I don't want. And I think that was quite nice. So number one, when you look at the list is not coming from employers saying we need this type of employers. I think that list you will get it from the Department of Employment and whatever industry. That is where the list comes in, because that's where the employers come in and say we are still looking for such a person. It's a different one. This one that the Minister of Higher Education is talking about is looking at the long-term side of things, because it's looking at after 3, 4, 5, 6 years after you complete your degree, would that still be in high demand? And it's looking at the broader things. The one from the employment department could just mean that if a company, if something else is a company, wants to develop its website and it wants to rephase everything, and then they just want high level of developers, for instance, that can skew the employment market, because at that point we might be thinking that, oh, we need a lot of financial analysts. But it's just a short-term project related to say we need them on a temporary basis because of, and if you're not careful with that one, you can actually make the wrong assumptions to say, oh, because they're so high in demand, we can't even get them on a permanent basis, we can only get them on a contract basis. So I think that one you also have to be, you know, cautious when you look at it. Companies can hire high demand today. They finish the project and then they don't need the same workforce for the next project. And then you have to move back to your consulting company so that you can find another project. This is where you see the consulting warehouses, if I call them, consulting firms are so high with, you know, consultants. And then what they do is they'll send you to different projects based on demand. That one is more linked to the job market. This one that they're looking at, it's looking at if today you were to go and start a new career, which program would probably give you the highest return for your time? And that's where I want us to look at it from that side of thing. So from the list itself, when you look at it, if you go to the link below, linked there, it's a long link. So the nice thing about that link is, maybe I'm gonna try to shorten it, then also put it on the comment. The link sends you straight to the report. The report is a little bit dated. It was done in 2012. But the reason why I wanted to talk about this report here is not for you to go look at the 2012 one. It's for you to look at what type of reports or programs are there. More especially if you are about to, you know, talk to your niece or your nephew that are still in finishing up high school, you can actually send them here and guide them accordingly. So the list, what it does is it's coded into three colors. What I also wanted to mention is that what they did with this list, the 2020 list, included about 345 companies. They just didn't just do what the university is saying. They also included what little bit of what the companies is saying. So you get, like, it's a balance. It's not the whole thousands of companies that are registered in South Africa, but just 345, which is a good sample to say. What skills are you looking for? The list has got three colors. You probably would look at the one in red. And then on the side there, they tell you what's the minimum. What's the minimum that's required. Like, so for instance, here we have like a financial manager. So it has a little code there. So it's a financial manager. And on the side, it says what's the minimum qualification required. It's a bachelor in honors, bachelor or a postgraduate degree or a bachelor's degree. But normally they are looking at NQF, National Qualification Framework, level 8. Must be like in an honors level to get there. But it is not green. It is white because there's a lot of finance people. I'll tell you about my story when I started in finance. And I decided, you know what, I'm going to informatics, which is the right word that they call it. When you look at the other ones, like their IT skills are not red, they are green. So it means there's still a potential. You can still go and then into those skills. They are green. Sorry, in my head, I was looking at the other one, the rose red. Under the green, you're looking at ICT system analyst, which is a different type of analyst. But to go in there, you know, you can just become a system analyst with a degree, which is why like graduate programs are quite good. Once you get that, you are in. But it means you cannot actually, it becomes difficult to go in with just a trick higher certificate. So it's a little bit that stuff like programmer analyst also needs a degree, which is still also green. The minister spoke about data scientist. Yes, we need quite data scientists, but it is in low shortage, and you know the salaries are quite, you know, sometimes you can earn as more than managing directors in small companies or medium companies for data scientists. And they are looking at NQF level 7, which is a degree or advanced diploma. So from there, that's the minimum that they're looking for. They can actually empower you until you get to a master's and you get, you know, all those things. I think the junior data analyst is the ones that their salaries are not the MD's one. The ones that the salaries the MD one is the one that has practiced for quite some time and has got all the qualifications, so they are quite high. So most of the IT analyst related things, which I would say it's ICT analyst, it's program analyst, it's quality assurance analyst, the site that I'm just looking at, they are all green. The blend that I did, because remember I'm doing accounting informatics, that one is a little bit on the white, because what you're looking at there, it's at the beginning, you're taking accountants, and then you're taking informatics side of things. So For me, because I was already on the accounting side, and I realized 2008 when I first walked in, after a couple of months, I realized, you know what, there's quite a lot of us who can do this. And I saw, you know, my salary was not going as fast as the other guy who was sitting next to me, who did quantitative analyst. We were sitting on the same open plate. By that, then I realized, you know what, I'm going to take finance and I'm going to join it with that quantitative stuff. And I'm going to become a finance analyst. So I somehow cooked it up to become there. I've realized that the universities are offering that, where they call it accounting and informatics, which is very, very nice. As you do the accounting degree, they try to tell you about the benefit of having your own accounting data. I think they call it not financial intelligence, but something else. There's a financial, it slips my mind that they're talking about there. So it, in a way, it makes you want to, you know, own your own data, analyze your own data, and then do your own reporting. That is all going into that niche market that I once created for myself. So if you were to start and you say, I'm starting from day one, I want to become, you know, an analyst that does all the data like myself, I would say you must be very, unless if you have a sponsor, better yet, if you have already have an employer who is saying, you know what, if you can actually get yourself this skill, I'm willing to employ you, then I would say yes. If you don't have such an employer, I would say think about the skills in this report that are either in red or either in green, if you are to start in 2022 probably. But about 2022, be on the lookout for another list. It might come out if you're thinking about doing your studies in 2023, or, you know, enhancing your career. Just look at that, because most of us, you know, we've been sent to management training and all of that, but there's a lot of us who can do that. All of us can become coaches, all of us can become leaders, all of us can do all of those things. And we have, you know, on the internet, we have people also telling us about rural on how easy it is to do it. For you to actually stay there and make it a career, it becomes a little bit, you know, very difficult. Unlike where I grew up, we had this one doctor, and the doctor was there for many years. Even today, he's still practicing medicine. He's just a general practitioner, a GP. But now he has, you know, he's in charge of other things, because he was a scarce doctor in there. There hasn't been enough supply of doctors to actually dilute the market. There are nurses, there are whatever, but they're also in short demand. Especially after the pandemic hit, we realized that the people in the healthcare professional are not quite that much. So if you're looking to become an analyst, I would say look for an analyst in a different field, a field that is in scarcity. If you're looking to become a general worker, or anybody can do that. The nice, another thing that everybody's talking about in the internet is becoming investment analyst. When I did finance, which included investment management, it was in very, very scarce. In this report, it was in the green or in the red in this space, but it wasn't in this report. It wasn't in the report back then. It was highly, highly, highly scarce, and they joined it. They made it a new qualification called Become Finance, which is financial management and investment management together. So for me, I would like to say, which jobs are you more likely to get employed in South Africa once you are done with whatever you are doing? I would say, don't look for what the person next to you says. Rather go look at what the report of the job market says, and also look at what the report of the universities, you know, the higher education says, before you start to read the brochure, because that brochure is a marketing tool. The marketing tool will say anything that they want to say. The research that they've done here is the one that will tell you to which decisions to make. For today, I can show you what I have in mind. Look lucrative, but maybe for you to start, it might not be lucrative. But have a balanced life, and then you can decide if you want to become a financial analyst, or if you want to become a software analyst, or you want to become other type of analyst, you know, information security analyst, or whatever the case is. But look at the scarcity of what you are doing, and then become an analyst in that field. So it might be something else that I'm totally always in the lookout for. But thanks guys for watching. We'll chat again next time.